Eternity.
You've got to learn how to walk with God through the valley of the shadow of death, of being the first person in a second position, and still have the fire to tell the enemy, I am anointed and you are appointed, and the victory shall be mine. Because when God gets ready, he's gonna flip the script.
Be still now. I am with you. I am deep within you. You are at peace. You cannot be harmed. You will not suffer. Breathe deeply. Breathe in the healing love of the universe. And breathe out the sickness which has taken you. I am with you.
There has to be a cross before there's a resurrection. Oh God, I feel it. So because you're in your cross stage, just go on and die. Because it takes the cross. Somebody say, I got to go through this. Tell somebody else, say, the quicker I get through this, the quicker I get my blessing. Oh God, there must be a resurrection on the other side. So the devil thinks he's got me scared, but no, he's just dating that I'm closer to my blessing by the pressure that I'm feeling. So there must be promise. If there is not promise, then the just lives by sight and not by faith. It's promise why I'm walking in here. It's promise why I can tell the devil no. It's promise why I won't accept his second, because God promised me the best. It's promise why I can get up every morning with my head stretched out and I say, is this the day? Is this the day? Is this the day?
It's easy. It's like breathing. It's like a heartbeat.
I know why I'm being attacked. Because the devil senses an anointing in me that he's trying to put out. The appointed without being anointed conceived it was his duty to repress Jeremiah. Whenever you deal with folk that don't understand anointing, they will try to put you in a bottle. But my friend, God just huffs and puffs till he blows you out. Touch your neighbor, say, you can't control me. I'm anointed.
I can still feel you, 'cause
The supernatural is always is. I feel like preaching now. You know where I am. Let's have some church. Touch somebody, say was, is. Touch somebody, say anointing is. Your birth was. Who your daddy was. Who God is. He is my Jehovah Jireh. He is my Jehovah Shalom. He is my Jehovah Maccabeesh. He is my Jehovah Rofika. He is my Jehovah Roah. He is my Jehovah Nisi. He is my Jehovah Sikadu. And is going to be over, was, any day. I'm getting ready to call and say, but I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Jeremiah refused to complain, sad in his heart, but one day it hurt him so bad. He said, Lord, thou hast deceived me. In other words, I'm totally gone, because I don't understand what I'm going through. I thought by now everything would be all right, but the more anointing I get, the meaner the folks are. With all the gifts that you've shown me, that by now folk would line up behind me and feel like I'm the best thing in the world. But it looks like the greater the anointing, the greater the affliction. But I'm beginning to find out that what I have is a real anointing. Because if it wasn't real, I'd have quit a long time ago. Shake somebody's hand, said I tried to quit, but the fire would not go out. I feel like preaching tonight. I feel like lifting him up. I know the Holy Ghost is here. I know it's real. They tried to wet me. They tried to walk on me. They tried to wipe me out. The conspirators met. The liars had counsel. I had shadows and difficulties on all sides. But every time I said to myself, I'm walking out of here, something on the inside comes alive. I've been disappointed, but it won't go out. I've been talked about, but it won't go out. I've been walked on, but it won't go out. I've been hurt, but it won't go out. They tried to take my church, but it won't go out. They tried to tear me down, but it won't go out. Something on the inside is like fire shut up in my bones. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Shake somebody's hand. Tell him it won't go out. They tried to shut me up, but I got more joy than I ever had. They tried to kill me, but every time they leave me, I bounce back up with a fresh anointing. The fire.